please rise as I present to you the Asbury Park High School candidates for graduation for the class of 2022.
Thank you.
have the presentation of the flags. Please rise, stay standing. Please rise for the presentation of the flags.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing for our national anthem and the African American anthem.
Thank you.
Color guard, you may recess.
Welcome, I'm Ava Herrera, our student council president and valedictorian.
And I'm Jayani Murray, our debate team captain and president of the class of 2022. We will be the conferenciers for our commencement ceremony this evening.
It is my pleasure to introduce our principal of Asbury Park High School, Mrs. Kathy A. Baumgartner, for the ceremony welcome and greeting.
Good evening, everyone. Come on now. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the 2022 Asbury Park High School Commencement Ceremony. Parents, you made it. Or shall I say, we made it. Yes. At this time, I would like all of you to help me welcome our superintendent of Asbury Park Public Schools, Dr. Rashawn Adams.
Good evening, everyone. Come on, you can do better than that. Good evening, everyone. So I have a couple of things. Today is a celebratory moment. For many of you as parents, you're looking at your children and you're saying, wow, not only did high school go by very fast, but the last 12 years went by in a blink. Some of you are reflecting on the first day of kindergarten. Some of you are reflecting on your journey to America, looking for a better opportunity for your children and yourselves. Some of you were transitioning into this community as we were transitioning. We all dealt with the results and the impact of the pandemic. We all came out on the other side. So we're here to celebrate the resilience of our students, of you, and of this community as a whole. So give yourselves a round of applause for that. To the students that are graduating today, it's pretty ironic that these were my first sixth graders back in 2015 when I arrived in the district. So many of them, Shamik, Liddell, Sky, we have extensive memories, and I'm sure they didn't really think that I would be calling their names at the podium on graduation, but please give these students a round of applause, all of them. We celebrate today not only the students, but we celebrate the career of Ms. Kathy Baumgartner, who is retiring. So please stand up, Ms. Kathy Baumgartner. Ms. Baumgartner has dedicated the last 20 years of her life to education. And I believe the majority here in Asbury Park, going from a vice principal to the principal of Obama, or Bangs at the time, then to Obama, and then to the high school. Excuse me? And Bradley. You know, forget Bradley. Okay, thank you. We got that. Double check. I'm going to put a third one, okay? Check, check, check. And so a lot of these students, she has seen not only as entering our district, but now exiting with her. And so we want to give her a standing ovation for her dedication to us and this community in Asbury Park. So please stand. So I won't be too long because you're not here to hear me speak. We have a long program and the air conditioner seems to be working on minimal right now. And I got this gown on and this hat and I'm definitely sweating. So we do have with us representing the Department of Education, Dr. Les Richens, who is going to come and bring greetings on behalf of the Acting Commissioner, Angelica McMillan, this evening. But I would be remiss prior to Dr. Richens coming up if I did not recognize our board members who were sitting in the front row. So would the Asbury Park board members please stand up and be recognized. So my last bit is our Dream Scholars. Yes. This is their second graduation. Not only in earlier May, they graduated with their associate's degree from Brookdale Community College. Will the Dream students please stand? Let me say it again. They have a college degree already. 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 Let me say this to you. These students and the families and the parents, I want to say thank you for entrusting us here in Asbury Park School District to provide that opportunity to your children. It is an opportunity that you will only get here if you are a resident and a student here in Asbury Park School District. So believe we have the better option than what is predicated out there. We offer our students the best options. And this is a testimony to the dedication and the belief of you as parents and our staff and what we offer here in Asbury Park. So I say thank you from the bottom of my heart for trusting us to provide that for your children. You may be seated. So I'm going to step off, I'm going to wipe my bald head, and I'm going to bring up Dr. Richens, who's going to bring us greetings from on behalf of the Acting Commissioner of Education for the state of New Jersey. Thank you.
Well, you rehearsed it twice, so let's hear if... Good evening.
Good evening.
All right, we got it right. Good. The Acting Commissioner of Education cannot join us tonight. However, Dr. Angelica Allen McMillan asked me to represent her and present to you her remarks. I hope I do them well, and I hope I do them right. And I hope that you get something out of this. Graduates, please excuse my back. I hate you have to look at the back of my head and my bald head. But hopefully you'll hear the remarks. Congratulations, class of 2022. Graduating high school is a phenomenal accomplishment, and you deserve every accolade that you receive today. Please relish in this moment. For this is the moment when the class of 2022 can reflect on your incredible fortitude, particularly since March 2020, when the COVID-19 pandemic changed our lives. High school is a historical time for change. But you had the added challenge of adjusting to the realities of shifting learning modalities. All of you remember the remote learning. Your path will continue to be forged by what you have persevered through the hope, healing, and resilience you exhibited. While we acknowledge the past, today we also focus on the future. Like every other part of life, time keeps moving forward. Today is a day of celebration and anticipation of what's to come. I am inspired to see how your unique past influenced the world you have opened to you. I know you will continue to keep the momentum of this moment, the culmination of the years of dedication to achieve your plans in the pursuit of your dreams. As a member of Generation Z, how many did you know that they are Generation Z? You are the first generation of the two digital natives, according to McKinsey and Company. Long before the term influencer was coined, young people played that social role by creating and interpreting trends. Now a new generation of influencers has come on the scene. Members of Generation Z, sitting behind me. Loosely, people born from 1995 to 2010 are true digital natives. From earliest youth, they have been exposed to the internet, to social networks, to mobile systems. You are all witness to that because all you see them doing is texting or looking or texting. They're not talking, but they're communicating. That context has produced a hyper-cognitivity generation, very comfortable with collecting and cross-referencing many sources of information and with integral virtual and online experiences. Whatever pathways you pursue, post-graduation, enrollment, employment, and I saw a young man, I don't know how many others saw it, and I don't know how many are going in to serve our country, but if anyone is enlisted, I know there's one young man wearing his army staff, and he passed me by. Are there any other young people enlisting? Please stand up. Any of you joining the military? What a dedication, what an inspiration. Envision what you will take on your journey, what you will have learned and discover about the world and yourself. Thank you to the proud parents, guardians, and caregivers who have partnered with teachers and other educators to prove an elastic web of support for your child that was unbreakable. The Brookdale graduates.
Yeah.
And I'm on the board of trustees, so I have a double, I can take some honor in this a little bit. And I can also say I can remember when this program started in Asbury Park. What an accomplishment. What an accomplishment. And everyone else, what an accomplishment. You're graduating a great high school tonight. I'm going to end the commissioner's speech from a quote from U.S. Senator Cory Booker. And this is something for you young people to remember, because there's going to be a lot of obstacles, you know, roadblocks. Everyone wants to throw something at you. You can dodge or weave, you know, and they won't hit you. Real courage is holding on to a still voice in your head that says, I must keep going. It's that voice that says nothing is a failure if it is not final. That voice that says to you, keep going, I will not quit. Keep that in your head. I will not quit. Have a wonderful celebration tonight. Congratulations to the parents. Congratulations to the graduates. Enjoy this evening. Thank you very much.
At this time, we would like to welcome up our district board president, Ms. Karita Cook, for a few words.
Hello, everyone. Good evening. So I'll make this short and sweet because it's not about me, it's about these kids. I just want to say congratulations to everyone for working really hard and succeeding. And please continue to believe in yourself and work really hard, and you'll be able to exceed whatever you want to do. Thank you. They prefer the digital versus the paper, so give me a second, folks. Isn't that great? Okay, there we go. Okay. Jayani, you're up.
Please give a warm welcome for Jashawn Lewis, Esther Paul, and Rocio Vasquez.
Members of our Board of Education, our superintendent, Dr. Adams, our principal, Ms. Baumgartner, faculty, staff, family, and fellow classmates, welcome to the commencement ceremony for the class of 2022. Each and every one of you have had an impact on the success of the soon-to-be graduates before you. We thank you for your love and support. Today marks the culmination of 12 long, challenging years of education. Now on with our program, thank you for joining us in our celebration.
Members of the Junior Education, the Superintendent, Dr. Adams, the Dr.
Is it yours? This is yours.
Oh, I was like, just. Mancomo said. Con education, Superintendent, no, say, Dr. Adam, Dr. No, Madam, Ms. Baumgartner, Facilitea, Anapwe, Fonim, Ake, Comrade Class, yo, Ake, ye, non, Simon, Comsonion, Class 2022, Shaq classmate Moyo, welcome to commencement no ceremony for class 2022. Pour tout moun ki vini jodi a, nou wè tout student yo ki impacte la vi yo, ki gen success, kap graduate devan nou la. Nou di mersi pou love ou support. Today marks culmination of 12 long, challenging years of education. Kunya with our program. Thank you for joining us.
Miembro de la Junta de Educación, nuestro superintendente, el doctor Adams, nuestra directora, señora Baumgartner, profesores, personal, familia y compañeros de clase, bienvenidos a la ceremonia de graduación de la clase de 2022. Todos y cada uno de ustedes han tenido un impacto en el éxito de los futuros graduados. Antes que usted, Les agradecemos por su amor y apoyo. Hoy marca la culminación de 12 largos y desafiantes años de educación. Ahora vamos con nuestro programa. Gracias por acompañarnos en nuestra celebración.
At this time, the president of the class of 2022 will present her class address.
Good evening. My name is Jayani Murray, and I am the senior class president. Welcome to the 2022 commencement ceremony. First, I would like to thank God for everything that He has done for me in my life and for giving us this day to gather for this momentous occasion. In addition, I would like to thank our superintendent, Dr. Adams, the Board of Education, and all the administrators, especially Dr. Howard Morris and Mrs. Baumgartner. I would also like to give a special thank you to Mrs. Wright and Ms. Herrera for supporting us and leading us on up to this milestone. Most importantly, I would like to thank our families and friends for supporting us on this long journey. It takes a village to raise a child, and that support system is what helped us get here today. For me, my mom, grandma, aunt, and big sister have played an influential role in helping me become the young woman that I am today. To be honest, my whole family has helped me get to this point. If it wasn't for them pushing me to be great, I might have given up. But perseverance is key, and that's what they taught me. So, class of 2022, we made it. Please give yourselves a round of applause. I would like to congratulate my fellow Dream Scholars for not only obtaining a high school diploma, but an associate's degree as well. I think that deserves another round of applause. This road has been very extensive and difficult, but this is just the beginning. I would also like to thank my classmates for the amazing times and memories that we have shared. One of my favorite memories has to be one of the numerous times that Ms. Ray had yelled at us for laughing too loud or playing around too much, which was always the case. These memories have pushed us to grow closer and become a family. We have helped each other get through this crazy time we call high school. Whether it be through laughter, having study sessions, or calls late at night trying to figure out how to do an assignment. Acquiring this family-like bond has made managing our senior year so much easier. In the midst of the pandemic, we had to learn how to navigate digital learning and being a college student online while also attending high school. It wasn't easy, to say the least. At times, one could say overwhelming and challenging, but we made it. Through trials and tribulations, we overcame it all. That sense of family has taught me how to create bonds that I never thought I would. At first, it was a little rocky, but now look at us. I said all this to say, enjoy the time you have and live in the moment. Some advice that I want to give my class is that this is just the beginning. After today is when your life truly begins. Make the best of it. Don't forget the lesson that you've learned here, and remember, bishops always persevere. Ms. Baumgartner, would you please join me on the stage?
We're gonna give her virtual flowers. Yeah, we don't have them right now, so thank you. Class of 2022 and the entire APHS family, we would like to thank you for being an amazing role model and leader to us, the staff and students. Best of luck in your retirement. We will miss you. Next up, we have the salutatorian for the class of 2022, Jillian Bedward.
Good evening, Asbury Park High School administration, teachers, staff, family, and the class of 2022. We finally made it. I want to welcome you all to our graduation and thank you for being here. This ceremony is both a celebration of what we have accomplished and a challenge for us to strive for even greater heights. To my family, I would like to say that your love and support had made all the difference. The encouraging words, the shoulders to cry on, ensuring I was on top of my assignments, and all the contributions to our education have not gone unnoticed. We owe great gratitude to the Asbury Park High School faculty, staff, and administration. There are many students who others may have disregarded, but you never gave up on us or our ability to reach our highest potential. The going was challenging at times, but you motivated us to clear the hurdles in our path, stay in the proverbial race, and see what we are truly made of. For that, we are thankful beyond words. Finally, to the Asbury Park High School class of 2022, I leave you with these seven things to keep in mind. One, go after dreams, not people. Two, love yourself and the rest will follow. Three, never lose your sense of wonder. Four, you are capable of more than you know. Five, no regrets in life, just lessons learned. Six, your only limit is you. And finally, seven, life goes by in the blink of an eye, so live it. I am grateful that I was a part of this cohort, and I hope the years to come are just as great. Unity is what makes us strong, so let the bonds we forge carry us through life's many challenges and be the bedrock that grounds our future successes. Congratulations, class of 2022. We made it.
Please welcome our valedictorian for the class of 2022, Ava Herrera.
Good evening, classmates, staff, families, administration, Board of Education members, and other distinguished guests. We had quite an interesting four-year experience. We saw a first ever woman of color elected vice president, former Senator Kamala Harris. A pandemic hit and suddenly we had to ration toilet paper. We all adapted to virtual learning and Zoom became a household name. Google no longer just meant look it up. It now referenced a way to write documents, a platform on which we could conduct class and learn, as well as a means to turn in schoolwork and have almost instantaneous grading and feedback. I've always done well academically when allowed to work at my own pace, and I prefer to work independently first, and then collaborate with my peers. This new virtual school actually helped me to de-stress a bit as our air quality increased with the reduced auto emissions. Gandhi said, "Speak only if it improves the silence." Stephen King stated, "Quiet people have the loudest minds." I agree with them both. I have found that I can observe my surroundings and take in much more information if I'm still and quiet. Think about it. If you are so busy having a conversation, are you really listening? Are you even trying to absorb information and understand your surroundings? My challenge to you, my classmates, is to slow down for a moment. Breathe in and out. When you are feeling overwhelmed and stressed and you just want to quit, don't. Take a short break. Go for a walk or a drive. Enjoy your friends and family. And then get right back to work. Do not procrastinate. Be proactive and also advocate for yourself. If a college professor has not issued clear directions, send them an email to ask for an example or a restatement of the task. Remember, you are never alone. Asbury Park High School is a family. Reach out for support and advice when you need it. I would like to take a moment and share a few memories with you and extend my gratitude. One of my first courses at Asbury Park High School was Dr. Abu's Honors History class. We had weekly debates and we communicated by blogging about class assignments. The challenge was to comment on a fellow student's remarks without repeating the verbiage they had employed. This became a fun game of utilizing a thesaurus to try to outdo our peers' use of vocabulary. What we did not know that we then was when we were preparing to do virtual learning. We did not need to be in the classroom to collaborate, to do research, and to write and revise our essays. Thank you, Dr. Abu, Mr. Nunez. I'm still not fond of math, but I thank you for teaching us to look for patterns and to use better test-taking strategies to pass our state tests. Mrs. Daniels, thank you for making English more interesting than some of my prior classes. Mrs. Wright, for always communicating with the Dream Academy and keeping us updated on any schedule changes. Thank you, Ms. Turpin, for always asking me how I was doing, what was new, and showing interest in my nails or outfit choice. Thank you. In my other elementary school, I could go months without anyone inquiring as to how I was feeling. This was acceptance, and sense of family is unique at APHS. Mr. Hackett and Ms. Stein for hunting me down to complete and submit my many scholarship applications. I thank you for helping me earn almost $8,000 towards my Pace University expenses. Ms. Rios, for all you do for our senior class, student council, and National Honor Society, thank you. Mrs. Baumgartner, for 4 years, you have supported all of our student council activities, class of 2022 ideas, and National Honor Society community service and other projects. Thank you. Mrs. McMillan, for being super organized and a perfectionist like me, for being a great biology teacher and an even better National Honor Society advisor, thank you. For always pushing me to get out of my comfort zone, to take a leadership role, and for always making me laugh, I am forever grateful. In an effort to shorten this program, let me just say another huge thank you to Dr. Repelette, Dr. Gray, Dr. Adams, and the whole administrative team, along with the Board of Education, for initiating and promoting the Dream Academy. I earned my associates in social sciences from Brookdale Community College as a distinguished scholar in May with a 3.9 GPA. Pace University's average cost of attendance per year is about $77,000. All of my college credits were accepted, and I will only need to attend another 2 years to earn my bachelor's degree in communications and mass media. Thank you to Pace University and the Honors College for awarding me over $32,000 a year in academic scholarships. Thank you also to Mr. Mitchell for hiring me at Sodexo. I have been able to save all of my paychecks to use for college books and supplies. Thank you to my family for always supporting me in my choices. Dream big and do not let anyone dissuade you from your chosen path. I aspire to be a best-selling author someday. I also want to try my hand at publishing and will hopefully be able to promote the publication of works by youth or minority authors to help their voices be heard. Special thanks to NJ Senator Vin Gopal for awarding me a $2,000 scholarship. Perhaps one day we will be able to collaborate on a publishing project. I cannot express my extreme gratitude to each and every organization who selected me as the recipient of their scholarship. Asbury Park High School and School District, I will return to offer scholarships to others. There will be a good return for the investment you have made in me. I have plans and I continue to revise my life goals. Class of 2022, good luck with all of your plans and best wishes to each of you in all of your future endeavors.
We are so grateful to have our keynote speaker, Mr. Julio Morgan.
Morgan is a product of Asbury Park. He was raised by a strong, independent woman, Annette Morgan. She gave him his roots and was a great example of hard work and willingness to do for others no matter what. Julio grew up in the Washington and Lincoln Village for most of his childhood. He is a graduate of the Asbury Park School District, graduating as a member of the class of 2000. Julio earned a BS in Computer Science Information Systems from Stockton University and a Master's in Business Administration from Eastern University. While at Stockton, Julio was elected the first African-American Greek Council President and Vice President of the Student Senate. In the spring of 2001, Julio pledged Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Inc. at Stockton University. He is a charter member of the Beta Beta Delta chapter. Julio served as the New Jersey State Director for the fraternity at one time. After completing his undergraduate degree, Julio went to work for the Division of Gaming Enforcement and the Casino Control Commission. He was responsible for conducting information technology security reviews in an industry that generated over $5 billion in gaming revenue. Julio began his McDonald's career at 15 years old, working in his adoptive mother, Marty Gill's first location in Neptune, New Jersey. He worked all through high school, eventually getting promoted to shift manager during his senior year of high school. After a couple of years of working in the casino gaming industry, Julio knew that his real calling was to become a McDonald's owner slash operator. While still working in his field, he took the McDonald's management training classes. In 2012, after much discussion with his family, he left his job to join the family business with no guarantees. Julio started as the general manager of the exact Neptune location that he began in when he was 15 years old. Marty made it clear that he would not grow up within the company if he could not develop the business and his replacement. So, over the next 6 years, Julio focused on creating a robust infrastructure that grew from 5 to 11 restaurants. In 2018, Julio became an approved next generation owner slash operator. Julio and Marty own and operate 20 McDonald's restaurants throughout New Jersey, Monmouth County, Middlesex, Somerset, Ocean, and Bergen County, and upstate New York markets. He prides himself in running outstanding restaurants, giving back to the communities they do business, and creating opportunities for other young men and women. He is currently the Chief Operating Officer of the Gillis Foundation organization. He is responsible for developing and executing the company's strategic plan for growth in sales and guest counts, profitability, people development, and reinvestment. In addition, Julio is the chair of the McDonald's Stamford Field Office and the treasurer of the National Black McDonald's Owner slash Operator Association. Julio is married to Larissa Morgan, a manager for clinical talent acquisition at Penn Medicine. They have two beautiful girls, Brielle and Sage. Please welcome Mr. Julio Morgan.
I still use paper, so I'm gonna turn this off. Hey, baby. Okay. Good afternoon, Dr. Adams, Mrs. Baumgartner, Dr. Howard Morris, members of the Board of Education, teachers, staff, parents, guests, and most importantly, the class of 2022. Thank you for inviting me as the 2022 commencement speaker. This moment is truly a homecoming for me. 22 years ago, I was here on these grounds waiting to receive my diploma and ready to leave for college. The only thing that stood in my way was the commencement speaker. With that said, I'm not here for a long time, but I'm here to leave you with five gems that I got from where you're sitting to where I'm standing today. First, class of 22, be unapologetically selfish. Remember, you're a 17 or 18-year-old young adult. With so much more life to live, do not think it's your responsibility to step up and step in right after graduation. It seemed like yesterday that my whole world came crashing down when my mother passed away months before graduation. My mind was all over the place. I knew I had to leave for college, but I was worried about my younger siblings. As the oldest, I thought about stepping up and filling those shoes was my job, until someone pulled me to the side and said, Julio, you're going to school. That's how you're going to be able to help your siblings, be an example for them. Class of 22, this is your time to figure out who you are, what path you want to take, and how you will take that path. And along the way, remember, have a lot of fun. Gem number two. What I'm about to say may not be a popular opinion, but it is fact. You do not have to attend college to make it in this world. But you do need an education to make it in this world. When I graduated in 2000, there was a great emphasis on going to college and how we would make something of ourselves. Coming from Asbury Park, a single mom trying to raise four kids, how do you think I paid for college? Yes, some scholarships, but the bulk was student loans, like many others. Let me share with you some numbers. The federal student aid states that $622 billion was borrowed by the age group of 35 to 49, which is my age group, which is the most considerable amount for an age group. The average student loan amount for that average group was about $45,000. So, if you're going into a field that will not carry that kind of debt load and allow you to live the life you truly want to, then I would look at all the options available. Joining the military is a great option, as long as there's no war. In addition, the military offers many benefits, such as training skills, free education, and you can see the world. So many of my classmates chose that option, and they've retired and enjoying a second career. Another option is learning a skill trade. Yeah, these are carpenters, painters, electricians, welders, plumbers, and skilled construction workers. According to the Bureau of Labor Statistics, these careers offer an average salary of $60,000, depending on the area. However, I believe that a person can make way more than the average with the high demand of these positions. And guess what? It will not cost you $45,000 to explore those careers. Remember, college is not the only path to success and happiness. Gem number three, see the world. In my junior year of college, I had the chance to go to South Africa. I don't mind paying that part of my student loan debt. It was such an eye-opening experience. The culture, the people, the landscape, the food, the views, they were all inspiring. Traveling allows you to get a different perspective on different cultures, and will enable you to form a better worldly opinion. The most important thing I can tell you about traveling is that it's good for you. Whether you're traveling three states away or planning a multi-continent hop, that trip will affect the change in you. It will help you grow and your bubble will burn brighter. Gem number five. See, this is going quick. Hard work does pay off. Class of 22, if I've not clarified, you will have to work hard to achieve all your success. As a young kid, I watched my mom work three jobs to make ends meet. I used to ask myself whether it would pay off for her. I guess it did, as I stand here as a testament to her. Marty Gillis didn't roll out the red carpet for me and hand me the keys to the business. I had to prove myself, which meant days, nights, weekends. I had to roll up my sleeves, put in a lot of sweat equity. Just as I watched Marty as a young kid, her hard work paid off as she grew the business from one location to the 20 locations we have today. I am also a testament of her hard work. So class of 22, I want you to understand you have to work hard to get what you want in life. Nothing is ever going to be given to you. Everything is going to be earned. Suppose you don't go out and put in the work and effort, then you will not get the results, and you don't deserve it, and you didn't earn it. Last gem. Now we bring it all back full circle. Once you've figured out who you are, what path you've taken, and had a lot of fun along the way, these are the times when you become selfless and help those needing help. These are the times when you now have the tools, experience, and resources to help those around you to do better and be better. It's not when you're 17 or 18 years old. Those are the moments to figure out yourself and your life. It's not till later that you will have the foundations to grab the next one by the hand and help them on the journey. It's the give back that is ultimately making us a better society. So, I'm humbled to have been asked to be the commencement speaker. I leave the class of 22 with the same thing I tell Brielle, Sage, and Marcus every morning. Be great and do great things. Thank you.
Senior class, please rise. For the singing of our alma mater.
Thank you. They only had a day to practice it. What happened, guys, is our football games, we used to do this as a fight song for all of our things, but COVID hit, so I apologize.
You may now be seated. Next, we have Bonnie, Nadia Ruiz, and Kiara Lysis to introduce our career technical education participants. Give them a round of applause.
Our Asbury Park High School Engineering Academy offers a four-year course of study in career and technical education for the engineering profession. Students in the program gain an in-depth knowledge of several engineering disciplines as well as learn technical skills such as the design process, apply physics and mathematics, prototype fabrication, robotics, and computer-aided designs. Students in the fourth year of program design and create a complex capstone project. Today, we recognize those students who have completed all 4 years of the Engineering Academy. Please rise and remain standing. Kevin Barksdale. Francisco Guzman. Samaya Love. Ricardo Mozo Mendoza. Johnny Murchison, Sakai Yi, and I myself, Bonnie Mescatito.
The Asbury Park High School Allied Health Academy is an associate of the Rutgers School of Health Professions Health Science Career Program. It's a four-year career and technical educational program. The program consists of four-credit undergraduate courses, Introduction to Allied Health, Medical Terminology, Anatomy and Physiology 1 and 2, and Principle of Nutrition. Student graduates with training of Certification in Patient Care Technician, OSHA, First Aid, CPR, and EED. Will the following students please stand up to be recognized and remain standing? Peter Altador. Oneid Harley Alexandra. Graciela Montes Osorio. Jacqueline Oliveira Montes. Ariande Garcia. Leisha Cajero. And myself, Nadia Ruiz. Please be seated.
The Law and Public Safety Academy is one of the premier programs in the Asbury Park School District, offering articulated college credits through Fairleigh Dickinson University and Criminal Justice, CPR, First Aid Certifications, and Pathways to Public Service, such as federal agents, state troopers, police officers, and EMTs, military and academic career paths. Please welcome to the stage the four-year participants. Mario Solis, Romero Cifuentes, Lizette Garcia, Alexis Castro, and myself, Kiara Lizes. You may now be seated.
Please welcome to this stage the advisor for the class of 2022 and my mother, Mrs. Gina Herrera.
I feel like we need a seventh inning stretch. Okay, thank you everyone. They're being so good. This is a hot and they're just being great, thank you. Good evening everyone, and thank you again for helping to raise and support such an amazing and talented and diverse group of young people. I would like to start by recognizing the top 10 students who have earned the highest cumulative GPA over their 4 years here at Asbury Park High School. Please rise and continue to stand as I call your name. In 10th place, Nadia Ruiz. In 9th place, Samaya Love. In 8th place, Gustavo Yeska Rope. In 7th place, Jayani Murray. In 6th place, Dakim Randolph. In 5th place, Peter Altador. In 4th place, Esther Paul. In 3rd place, Kashir Allen Johnson. In 2nd place, our salutatorian, Jillian Bedward. And in 1st place, our valedictorian, Ava Herrera. She always wanted to know when she was going to beat the other two siblings, and she finally did it, so. What is truly impressive is that 5 of the top 10 students are part of the Dream Academy cohort and were able to sustain these grades while simultaneously taking high school and college courses. Great job, all of you. Please be seated. Next, I'm going to recognize the student council officers. Again, please remain standing. Student Council President Ava Herrera. Vice Presidents Jayani Murray and Esther Paul. Secretary Jillian Bedward. Treasurer Kashir Allen Johnson. You may be seated. I would like to note that these individuals have all been members since freshman year, from planning homecoming to performing community service, such as working at the food bank, Fulfill, and raising funds for families experiencing food insufficiency, and participating in several local cleanup events. It is no wonder that all of these student leaders have earned several well-deserved college scholarships. It has been my pleasure and privilege to have been the advisor for the class of 2022 for their full 4 years here at Asbury Park High School. This group is even more special to me as my youngest child, Ava, is a member of the class. I apologize keeping you here daily until close to 5 p.m. I can't. We live here. And then dragging you to our local wholesale for Snack Shack refills. But I've truly enjoyed our conversations. I need to extend a huge heartfelt thanks once again to our school district, our Board of Education, our administrators, and everyone who participated in the development of such a revolutionary concept of the Dream Academy. Thank you also to our district grant writers. Also many thanks to Mrs. Margot Wright, who has helped these students acclimate to a life as a college student. From her gentle reminders that a paper was approaching its deadline to her more tough stance on using cell phones for non-educational purposes, we appreciate you. Class of 2022, I will truly miss you. Sky, Taj, Sal, I will miss your daily visits just to check in. Kiara, you'll have to text any and all future complaints, but you know, I'll always be here to hear you out. Kashir and Ava, I don't know what to do next year. Without all your help stocking, taking inventory, and working our senior snack shack, the funds help raise, reduce the cost of prom for many, many students. The rising seniors will certainly have some very large shoes to fill. Jayani, for all your leadership ideas, your amazing cookies for our bake sales, and your ever-present positive spirit, I thank you. Esther, what can I say? You are just such a sweetheart. Thank you for jumping in to tutor whenever I needed you, and even to translate to Haitian Creole for some of my ELL math students. Jillian, I have seen your entire personality blossom from freshman year. You are present at every meeting and always willing to pitch in on every project and also on tutoring. You will be successful at anything you wish to pursue. To the decorating crew, sometimes headed up by Graciela, I appreciated all your hard work. It was very nice getting to know some of you that I never had as students in my class. Staff who worked countless hours to grade all those late assignments to help ensure that we could get as many students on the stage tonight as possible, we thank you. Special thanks to Mrs. Lewis. Chem was hard for a lot of our kids. Mr. Nunez, Mrs. DeMarsco, Mrs. Francis, Ms. Matt, Ms. Stone, and the rest. Ms. Daniels, thank you for running the Senior Credit Recovery Program. We appreciate your organization and the thoroughness of all that you do. Mrs. Anna Marie Graff, for all your work with our Penn Foster individuals, we thank you. the entire guidance team. Without you, many of our scholarship applications would not have been submitted on time. Thank you. Mrs. Nancy Estrada, your help with the senior class has been invaluable. She's always behind the scenes, but she always, like, the glue, she puts us all together. Our security team, we could not do this without you. For every time you reached into your own lunch, and I saw it, to help out a student who needed a snack to tide them over to lunch, or you sent them to Snack Shack for a morning juice, or you just said, good morning, how are you today? You brighten up our halls with your compassion and your empathy. Mrs. Rios, Miss Jackie, Miss Mitchell, Miss Batson, Miss Bellamy, did I miss anyone? Miss Farrakhan, all of our administrative assistants, you rock. Seniors, I hope you enjoyed our trip to Pocono Valley Resort. I know you will treasure many of those memories, I will too, on our senior walk to all of the elementary schools. If I could have bottled only a fraction of the smiles I saw on those young children's faces as you paraded through the halls, we could generate electricity for all of Asbury Park for a year. Prom was spectacular. I'm so glad that we had such a great turnout. I was able to help create many more happy memories, and I loved it. By the way, gotpics.net 2022, you can see all of our prom pictures. Thanks again to our whole decorating crew, all of our student sponsors, The Spot, Mr. Julio Morgan, Ms. Veronica, Ms. Bricks, Mr. Gould, Goldie, I don't want to miss anybody, Ms. McMillan. Ms. McMillan is responsible for those beautiful programs. She's not here with us. She is the bomb. And many more for making it possible for some of our financial struggling students, to attend our event for free. For the continual support of our superintendent, Dr. Adams, the Board of Education, I would be remiss if I did not send a huge shout out to our principal, Mrs. Kathy Baumgartner. Your never-ending love and support for our students is commendable and often unparalleled. I'm two more pages, let me go. Should they know I'm loquacious? I don't get to do this. Many of our students consider you family. If you ever need planning or decorating for a party, don't hesitate to call. Dr. Howard Morris for filling in as acting principal during Mr. Baumgartner's recovery. We thank you for putting students first, supporting our student athletes. I can go faster. Okay, at this time I need to recognize the class officers, then we can get on with our program. Please stand and remain standing. Class President, Jayani Murray. Class Vice Presidents, Ava Herrera, Kashir Allen Johnson. Secretary Rocio Velasquez, Treasurer Jillian Bedward, Public Relations Coordinator Kira Lysias, did I do it right? Fundraising Coordinator Esther Paul, you may be seated. Thanks again to my family for tolerating my many hours away from home and for their perpetual willingness to assist whenever I need help. Our last paragraph. Class of 2022, I ask you to practice inclusivity. Continue to embrace and celebrate the differences in others. Please try to be adaptable, especially in work situations. This ranks as one of the most coveted characteristics of employees. And lastly, extend kindness to all of those around you. Kindness is free and highly contagious. I am here for you now, as well as in the future. Good luck to you all.
Just stay there. How about her speech was longer than the speaker? But Ms. Herrera, really, we want to extend our gratitude to you for all you do. And she does a lot. Yes. Anything we ask of her, selling hot dogs at the basketball game, whatever you ask of her, she does the prom. She obsesses over it. Today, she literally was in here for the past 3 days. I don't know that she left. She probably slept here on the stage to make sure everything was perfect. I thought she was a little strange when I first met her 6 years ago, but I have grown to love and appreciate her so much. So thank you for all you do. Okay, you can't talk no more though, so. All right, Jayani, come on.
Now, for the event that we've all been waiting for. of the diplomas. Mrs. Baumgartner, Dr. Adams, Ms. Coretta Cook, if you would please take the stage. Seniors, row one, please rise. Ava Herrera. Jillian Bedward. Jayani Murray. Jayani Murray. Kiara Lysias. Abigail Contreras. Jershawn Lewis. Joshua Handy. Samaya Love. Ariadne Garcia. Kaishir Allen Johnson. Peter Altador. Nadia Ruiz. Bonnie Mescatilla Garcia. Esther Paul. Nylea Cummings. Regina Michelle. Mervilyn Desroches. Dakim Randolph. Shamik Goodman. Gerardo Abarian Garcia. Oneid
Elijah Anderson. Emiliana Brown.
Azure Burris. Laisha Cajero. Stevens Cajulis. Anna Abigail Marino Mija. Imani Xavier Chatois.
Juan Davis. Diego Perez. Maritza Kudos. Diana Ramirez. Artemio Ramirez Lopez. Selena Ramirez Cruz. Maya Riano Azola. Liliana Rodriguez Hernandez. Deshae Rolfe. Christy Romulus. Zaire Davis. Savon Duffis. Lizeth Garcia Hernandez. Karina Garcia Hernandez. Marlene Gomez Barrios. Francisco. Jesus Hernandez Nava. Joel Herrera Perez. Santiago Ruiz. Elvis Ruiz Diaz. Rakeem Holmes Harris. Gerlandi Jean Pierre. Not gonna miss.
Rose Carm Joseph. Christian Labastida. Sakai.
Okay, we left out one little piece, the National Honor Society. So, Kashir, and Peter, come on up. And Rocio, come on up.
My name is Kashira Ellen Johnson. As you know, I am third in the senior class. I am also the president of National Honor Society, and I am vice president of...
Kashira, what number
senior
class?
Third. I'm third in senior class. But that's not all. I'm also treasurer of the student council and vice president of senior class. So, well, with me, I also have our other co-president.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Peter Altidore. I'm also blessed to have been part of Allied Health and Ms. Gogan. Shout out to her if she's watching us. With her, I have a certification for Christian Care Technician, so I can work at any hospital. A starting salary is 21, going up. You know how it is. I'm also number 5 in a senior class, and I'll pass the mic too.
Well, to continue, as you already heard, we are the co-presidents of National Honor Society. And the National Honor Society was a wonderful opportunity for us. And I am happy to have been inducted to it. Many of you might not know what National Honor Society is. So I will briefly inform you what the National Honor Society entitles. The National Honor Society raises a school's dedication to the values of scholarship, service, leadership, and character. These are the four pillars that have been associated with the membership and the organization since its founding in 1921. The National Honor Society for me was one of the best choices I have ever made in these high school years. I have volunteered, tutored, directed, and assisted in many activities and events for the school and outside of it as well. The National Honor Society helped me achieve many things and even given me new skills to use in my life later on too. This has been such an awesome time with the National Honor Society, and all I have to say is thank you to Ms. McMillan and to the National Honor Society for having me as its co-president for this year and for giving me such wonderful memories. I would also like to thank Ms. Baumgartner for watching me grow since elementary and for being there for me through it all. Lastly, I would really would like to thank my family, my mom and my sister, and my other sister, and my dad. Just to tell you, my sister was National Honor Society president too. And I would like to thank them for their support, influence, and push to get me to where I am now, successful. So before I even continue, I'll leave you a quote from one of my favorite philosophers, Friedrich Nietzsche. "There is no golden way to success. Something may work for your friend, but not for you. You need to learn from your mistakes and trust your gut to create your own path." Thank you.
Hello again, y'all. Again, my name is Peter Altidore, and I'll be doing a Creole version of the National Society speech that he just did. Programme National Society, I think I'm a belle experience for me. I'm content to inscrit. Get a look at what the program is, if you don't speak up. National Society augment the focus of the school to boost the team, service, leadership, and character. This is the 4 points of the program since 1921. Faire partie de la National Honor Society, c'est un plus bon choix que j'ai fait dans la secondaire. J'ai servi comme volontaire, enseigné, dirigé et aidé dans plus d'activités, ni l'école là, ni dehors l'école là. Le programme a aidé à me réaliser un plus de bagages, ensemble avec technique, pour plus de dans la vie. Environ, c'était une bonne expérience. Pour finir, je remercie Ms. McMillan, Ms. Baumgartner, et la Société Honnée Nationale là, parce qu'ils ont été choisis comme président de l'année. Et tout pour belle mémoire qui t'a avec. Also, y'all, special thanks to my family, my dad, my brother, the people that's attending online that they couldn't make it. I appreciate y'all. And especially my sister who's sitting over there. Because they're always there to support me and helping me make it through. This isn't the end, but this is a big step. And I'm just, you know, glad that they've been there with me. And this for my Haitian. Ça c'est une phrase préférée d'un philosophe qui est le Frédéric Nietzsche. Il dit, pas de aucune façon là pour succès. Yon bagay ka marche pour amour, mais il va marcher pour vous. Vous devez apprendre dans les rêves et puis faire entrer la confiance pour créer votre propre chemin. Merci. Thank you. Now I'll be calling out the National Honor Society members. Please rise when you hear your name. First, we have the co-presidents, myself, Peter Altidore, and cashier, Johnny Allen Johnson. Next, we have our secretary, Ava Renee Herrera.
Our treasurer is Jillian Bedward. And our senior members, Gianni, Regina, and Murray. We have Esther Paul. And finally, Rocio Vasquez Jimenez. Thank you. You may now all be seated. Thank you.
So yes, 2003, April 2003, I started in Asbury Park, so I've been here 19 years. Yeah. After teaching in Newark for 11 years, so you can do the math, 30 years, and I am retiring. I am ready. I am tired of getting up at 4:30 in the morning, and I'm ready to rest. But like Dr. Adams said, many of your children up here, I met them on the playground at Barack Obama when they were in kindergarten. And it's crazy to see Kashir, the growth. So many of them are taller than me. They were this big. So to be here, I feel it's an honor and a blessing and a pleasure to be here, you know, long enough that I could be here at their beginning and at their end. Many of you out there, parents, we've been together for so long. Yes, I appreciate you. I have come to know and work with and some of you are like family, like brothers and sisters. My staff in all of the buildings I've been in, Barack Obama, Bangs/Barack Obama, Bradley, Thurgood, which is really where I started, and now the high school. I've had the honor and privilege of working with some amazing educators, and My 19 years here at Asbury Park has truly been a blessing. So thank you. Thank you, and thank you. And I will still be on the sidelines at the football games. Now, with all of that, I would like to present to you the Asbury Park High School graduates of the class of 2022. Please stand. On behalf of the Asbury Park School District, the County of Monmouth, and the State of New Jersey, you are hereby duly certified as a graduating senior of the Asbury Park High School. You may move your tassels. Congratulations. Congratulations. And make sure you moved it to the left, because that's... All right. We did it. Y'all ready? Please keep the aisles clear so that our graduates, our alumni... No. All right, they got to get through the aisles, y'all. If anybody's going somewhere really good to eat, let me know. I'm starving. All right. Music. Maestro. Have a great summer, everyone. Please be safe.
Believe that life is a prize.